The image assets used in the Adobe Aero Tattoos to Life experience. And I'm going to show you just how to quickly and easily edit some of these, whether it's from color correction to transparent PNGs and image anchors. So first of all, we're going to just quickly edit this photo taken on the Oregon coast. We want to try and lighten up some of these darker areas, get a little bit more contrast in the whole scene. So we're going to make sure our document's selected and come up to Image and Adjustments. And we can go to Shadow Highlights. And that is immediately going to give us a lot more visible definition in our scene. So you can just preview that on and off and see. So we might bring down the shadows a bit and maybe up the contrast in the highlights. And we're just going to hit OK. And then just to take control of the color a little bit more, we're going to bring in the curves and try and control that contrast a little bit more by bringing down the dark and brightening up the top a little bit. So it gets us a bit more of a vibrancy in our color palette. So we would just merge that down and we would save that for our background to use in the AR experience. Then using our cloud from Adobe stock, we wanted to extract the white and have the black come through as transparency in our AR scene. So we're going to go up to select and color range. And by selecting the brightest part of the white, we'll then scale up our fuzziness to get a little bit more selection happening, hitting OK, and then Control J or Command J onto a new layer. And then deleting our background layer. And so that's going to give us a transparent background that we would then quick export as a PNG into our Creative Cloud folder. And for our image anchor background, we're going to want to create some high contrast elements in order for our image anchor to be easily readable when it comes to viewing in the AR app. So we're going to start by creating some thick border lines using the rectangle tool, making sure that we have our brown stroke color, and we're going to drag out and we're going to do two of those. And then we're going to want to create some typographic messaging at the top and bottom. So with our type tool, we're going to click in the center and add in our header. And having some of these graphic elements is really going to help when it comes to having a good track on your AR scene. So we'll shrink this down a touch at the bottom. And in order to get a bit of a consistent distress on all of these graphics, we're going to select all of them and then group them. And we're going to add a mask to that. And then we're going to turn those off. And then above our background, we want to create a gradient map that's black and white. And we're going to create a high contrast map to select from for our mask on the other graphics. So if we bring that up and then hit OK, and then come to our gradient, make sure that's selected. Go to color range, and then we're going to pick something in about 50% gray. And we want to make sure there's just a bit of grain selected. And then with that on, we can then hide our gradient map, turn on our graphics, and then we can fill that with black. And then you can see here that we have taken the grain from the background image and used it to distress our top image, giving a little bit more of a natural blend. And now we want to export that image as a PNG from File, Export, Quick Export as PNG, and we would save that to our Adobe Creative Cloud library along with all of our other assets ready to import into Adobe Aero. Now with our image anchor, we're going to duplicate that file so we can create a transparent ellipse center that'll allow our background scenery to show through. So we're going to grab the reference PNG from the 3D models pack, and that's going to help us get the right size of the ellipse. And we're going to bring that into our scene. And if we scale that down with the free transform, we're going to want to add a mask to our background. And then back on our rope frame, we're going to use the magic wand to select the center. And then back on our background frame, if we fill that with black, we have our transparent center. Then you can come up to File, Export, Quick Export as PNG into your library of assets. And make sure that it's saved with a duplicate file name ready for import.